once upon a future time in a place called Stardust Bay. Counting down to adventure now. Rockets on a mission, we're on our way. Space racers, surfing the solar winds. Space racers, together the fun begins. Where the planets, moons, and stars all shimmer, shine. Having a great time exploring space racers.
Hey, wait for me!
Dodo! Where in blazing blue comets are those files I asked for? It's been 5 whole minutes already! I haven't got all day, you know! You clumsy oaf! I need those files on my desk, not on the floor!
Yes, boss. Right away, boss. You can count on me, boss!
If one wants a job done right, I suppose one must do it oneself. Ow! Dodo, you sweet fellow and dear friend. Thank you, dear Dodo. You are a prince among rockets, a sage of the galaxy.
I am? Thanks, boss. You're that sage thing, too. And even better than a prince, you're a king!
And you are a treasured companion who gives me joy every day.
And you are a great boss who honors me around every day.
And might I say, you are absolutely adorable, Dodo.
And you're the bestest rocket in the whole universe.
And you are the cleverest.
And you're the kindest.
You are a credit to our academy, young rocket. Please allow me to help you with those heavy books. Mustn't strain those tender young muscles. My, aren't you a clever rocket?
5 floating rings, 4 fuel injectors, 3 planetoids, 2 training wheels, and an extra set of cargo bay doors.
My dear Coach Pigeon, please let me help you tidy up.
Thank you, but it's not necessary. You see, I...
No trouble at all, Coach. No trouble at all. There now, that's much better. Opens the room up, don't you think? No need to thank me. Happy to help.
Oops, I'm sorry.
No worries at all, young cadet. No harm done. There's a good lad.
Gee, thanks, mister. Whoever you are.
You don't know who I am? Why, I'm Vulture, your school board chairman. Here, please take one of these delicious fuel bars from my private supply. They're my favorite flavor, liver. Whenever you munch on one, you can think of me.
Thank you, I think.
Ah, youth, so full of promise.
More tea, Mr. Rocket Baby? Don't worry, Miss Pony. There's enough for you two.
Such a charming tea party. Is there room at the table for moi?
Well, Mr. Rocket Baby, Mr. Vulture would like to join us. Is that okay? He says yes.
How delightful!
Another fuel cookie, Mr. Vulture?
Why, thank you. I believe I will. Ah, the joys of nature, the warm sunshine, the lovely trees. Skaboodle-bop, ding-dong, bouncy-bing, the day is so bright. Ha-ha, I have to sing. Skabeedle-boop, flip-flop, fancy pants. My heart is so light, I have to dance.
Is that Vulture? He's acting all weird.
It sure looks like him, but he's...
dancing?
Rocket engines use thrust to achieve liftoff. Can anyone explain rocket thrust?
Rocket thrust is when you push in the opposite direction from where you want to go.
That's right. So when a rocket fires his thrusters down against the launch pad, he moves in the opposite direction. Up. This is also known as Newton's third law of motion. For every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction.
Bravo, Cadet Hawk. That was an expert definition of thrust. We need more smart young rockets like you in our world.
Hmm.
And you, Professor Coot, are a credit to the academic community.
Boss! Hey, boss, wait for...
Look. What in the name of velocity is going on with Vulture?
Well, he's...
He's so nice.
The boss is just...
It's like he's under a magic spell or something.
I suddenly love him! This is super weird!
We need to talk to
him. What brings all of you in here?
He's so nice!
Calm down, everyone. I cannot help if you all shout at the same time. Now, am I to understand that Vulture has been transformed into someone sweet-tempered and nice? That is odd. Do any of you know how this happened?
I dropped a bunch of files on the floor, and the boss went under the desk, and there was a loud bonk, and then he said I was his sweet friend, and... No, we hugged, and...
You are the soul of our school, Headmaster Crane, and I, for one, bow to your wisdom.
Huh?
La-da-da-da, da-dum-da-da-lee-da-da-da-da. Oh, what an exquisite perfume. La-da-da-da.
Is he possessed? It's not natural.
Unnatural indeed, Oh dear. My allergies. Oh, these flowers. Thank you, Coot. As a wise rocket once said, beware of school board chairman bearing daisies to those who are allergic.
The boss doesn't even like flowers. He says they don't belong in a school of science.
I never thought I'd say this, but we need the old, not-so-nice Vulture back. Yes, Dodo, we are a school of science. Say, that's it. Perhaps we can cure him with science.
How?
Maybe we can create a medicine that'll make him his normal self again. I'll start my calculations.
Or maybe we can find some cosmic dust to sprinkle on him.
No! We need a magic spell!
I admire your creative enthusiasm, cadets, but we need a more practical science. Dodo, tell us of Vulture's likes and dislikes.
Well... he likes soothing oil baths, and he likes big pictures of himself. And he likes to talk a lot, and he likes everyone else to be quiet and listen.
Oh, yes. Much better color coordination now.
My garden! What is he doing? We must act quickly, cadets.
Leave it to us, sir. We'll get this done. Dodo, what doesn't he like?
Mr. Vulture doesn't like surprises. He really hates those.
So if we can surprise him, it might shock him back to his old self.
Hey, wait up, boss!
Dodo? Why, Dodo, my dear Dodo. How are you doing today?
That's just it, boss. I wanted to ask you something.
Yes, Dodo? How can I help you? No! You mischievous little rockets! That was a good one indeed! Got you back.
Well, that didn't work.
Hey, what if we got him angry? Really, really steaming mad.
Yeah, that might snap him out of it.
I think I know just how to do it, too. Be right back. Hi again, Mr. Vulture. See this big, beautiful painting of you?
Why, yes.
Ha! That's better!
What an unhappy-looking portrait. I think we can make it even better.
Ah, what's it gonna take to cure him?
Dodo, didn't you say you heard a bonk sound when Vulture was under his desk?
Yeah?
I bet he hit his head under there. That's probably what caused this. So we need to use Newton's third law of motion.
And create an equal and opposite reaction.
Exactly. Guys, I think it's time for a little game of Orb-O.
Huh? Now? Oh. Hockey, would you please set me up for a quintuple fling za-za-zing?
Dodo!
Coming, boss!
What is the meaning of this? I gave you simple instructions to bring me some files, and suddenly find myself outside in bright sunshine, surrounded by flowers and trees! You know we do not do nature.
I know, boss. Sorry about that. No worries. Those files are coming right up. You can count on me.
Well, we did it. Good old Vulture, bad old Vulture, is back.
Skaboodle bop, ding dong bouncy bing, the day is so bright. I have to sing skabeedle boop. Flip-flop, fancy pants, my heart is so light, I have to dance.
Shabooly-bop, flip-floppy-floopy-doo, shabloopy-boopy, dangle-dingle-doodly-doo, da-da-da-da-dee-dum-dum-da-doodly-doo. Hey, boss, where'd the music go?